Ladies and gentlemen, our next session is called The Mind of Modi. We now speak to one of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's closest advisors, who's going to give us a unique insight into the priorities for the rest of his current term. Time now to find out how a challenging geopolitical backdrop is being used as a springboard for India's global growth. Please welcome onto the stage Vijay Chothawali, in charge of Foreign Affairs Department of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Please. Thank you very much for joining us. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much for inviting me.
Well, let's cast our minds back, first of all, to 2014 and PM Modi's first election victory. What was the ambition back then? And do you think that much of it right now has been achieved?
I think in 2014, after 10 years of the previous government, everyone was looking for a very credible alternative.
That's great, thank you.
That is not only free of any corruption, malpractices, but also the leader who would deliver the goods to the people. And that was the expectation, and I guess to a great extent, in last 7 years, Prime Minister Modi has delivered it.
So if we were with Prime Minister Modi now, what would you say are the two or three things that are currently keeping him awake at night?
It's very interesting because those who have seen today's newspaper, yesterday there was a very famous inauguration of a big corridor of in Banaras, which is one of the holiest places in India. And it was his vision to remove all the clutters and give a very nice and memorable access to the main temple. But after doing all those inaugurations and religious rituals, he went in the evening again, did a very sacred ritual in Banaras. Everyone thought that the day is over, but he actually, because that's his constituency also, he walked out at 1 a.m. in the morning with the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh and actually gone through the various development projects that are undergoing in his constituency. So what keeps him away? Always development, security. These are the issues which he's very passionate about, and I'm sure he keeps it 24 hours, he thinks about it 24 hours a day.
What would you say are PM Modi's, what is the current role on the international stage?
Well, India is at a stage where every critical issues that is facing humanity today, Indians and our leader, Mr. Modi, is playing a very crucial role. You take it, terrorism, you take climate change, you take COVID pandemic, and you take Afghanistan. These are the four major challenges the entire world is facing. And everywhere, India's role is seen crucial, not only pivotal, but it is giving the direction and the leadership to the entire humanity. And that is something which I would say is the great story to tell about India today. We are supplying medicines, we are supplying vaccines to millions and millions of people across the world. In the terrorism, our stand has been accepted and appreciated across the world when we did a strong action against cross-border terrorism. Entire world appreciated our courage. On the climate change, COP26, India's commitments are not only huge but also credible. And in Afghanistan, what India has done is I won't say cleverly, but very intelligently dissected between the humanitarian needs of Afghan people versus the prospect of growing terrorism and the drug menace coming out of Taliban regime. So India is supplying grains. In fact, millions of tons of grains have been supplied to Afghanistan by India after Taliban has taken over. And at the same time, we have taken utmost care that the past experience of Afghanistan being a hub of terrorist activities as well as the drugs should, the drug should remain, the world should remain isolated as much as possible. So on all four major issues which the entire world is facing today, India's role is seen as a crucial, and India is providing leadership. That's the great story for India today.
Here's an interesting question. I mean, how does PM Modi describe himself?
He has always considered itself as a kind of a janta ka sevak, means who would like to serve the people of the country. In a very famous text message which he has sent when he was the chief minister, after the victory, he, as a chief minister in Gujarat's state elections, he, you know, to a very famous journalist, he said, "I am always CM," which essentially means, actually could have been taken as a, "I am always chief minister," but actually what he meant was that "I am always common man." So that is the dual role which he could play very easily, that he understands that he is there, he is very conscious of his humble roots, and that has created his personality in a big way. Therefore, no success goes in his head, and no defeat actually discourages him from his mission to serve the people. And I guess that is keeping him growing and being very energetic throughout his career in politics.
What about some big announcements that we might be hearing from New Delhi in, let's say, the next 2 or 3 years?
No one knows. And it's, as I always say, that those who claim that they can predict about Mr. Modi, most of them go wrong. And those who know, then they will never claim that they know about him. So taking into that, and the kind of surprise element which always he gives to the people, it's very difficult. I am not an astrologer for sure, and I don't want to claim it. But I guess the consistency of his commitment to the people of India and the poor of India and downtrodden, to the states which are relatively underdeveloped, especially, for example, the states of Northeast, it is unequivocal. He has always talked about it, and I'm sure he will also continue to do more and more so that there is an equitable, sustainable development of the entire country and not only certain pockets of the country with large geography and large diversity as in, much as in India.
Now, Mr. Chathawali, as the BJP's foreign policy lead, what do you see the international community wanting to see India focus on in the coming period?
People across the globe are looking towards India, definitely in context of pandemic, how India has faced the pandemic, especially the second wave. Of course, we were not perfect there, and we know that it was devastating wave. But India could recover very quickly. The economy is growing again. It's on track. And we have given again support to many people across the globe by supplying of medicine and vaccines. So people think that India is a kind of democratic leader who not only cares about itself, but also cares about entire humanity. And Indian diaspora, which is also very prevalent here, has been very instrumental in giving that message to the entire world by their role and their commitment to the local communities. So I guess the diaspora has played a phenomenal role during the pandemic, and that is going to set the trend for other countries. Many of them, they have also supported back home to Indians who were in distress, and that also is a very exemplary case study in future, that how the global diaspora of any country can come together and support their country of origin. So these are some of the things I think will determine the future course of action. The third part is, of course, on a softer issues like health care in general would be very crucial for the entire world. Now the new variant is coming and there is no immediate in the horizon that pandemic will end. So in that respect also, India's role, India's holistic healthcare system is likely to play a very important role. So I think that in next 2-3 years, India will continue to provide leadership on several of these issues.
Now, you talk about the diaspora and, you know, here at the India Global Forum in the UAE, how important is the UAE on the agenda for India?
It has been talked about it for last 2 days, and I would like to reemphasize that the relationship between India and UAE has reached a new orbit in last 7 years. And thanks to the leadership of both the countries, Prime Minister Modi has visited to this country 3 times and he is likely to come again in 10 days' time. I guess first week of January, if I am not wrong. And the leadership of UAE has visited India twice. And in a very nice gesture, when His Highness Crown Prince of UAE was a chief guest of Indian Republic Day, a small contingent of UAE armed forces also took a part in the Republic Day parade along with Indian armed forces, which doesn't happen many a times in our history also. So many such things, and they are not only symbolism. For example, again, the Hindu temple of Abu Dhabi, Swamiji has already talked about. But again, there is substantial growth and diversity of arrangements between and agreements. For example, now India is investing in some greenfield oil fields here in UAE. So there are substantial talks about trades. I think we will see a tremendous progress in next 2-3 years in every aspect of India-UAE relations.
And what key lessons do you think can be learned from PM Modi and his, you know, his leadership style?
I think Prime Minister Modi is a very unique person in a sense that he has a grand vision. He has ability to work out a plan to achieve that vision, and he is a very very focused, laser focused on the nitty-gritties of that plan so that it is delivered on time. So while keeping a macro picture in the horizon, he doesn't give up the micro details. And while going into the micro details, he doesn't forget the big picture. That is the success of how the gigantic schemes like opening more than 300 million bank accounts in 1 year to more than 1.2 billion vaccine doses in less than 1 year. So you see the number, they are staggering. We have never imagined this kind of things happening in India with the diversity and all the complexity of the country. But why, and even you see infrastructure, roads, IT infrastructure, you name it, and there is a paradigm shift in the way people are looking. The financial transaction model which India has given has become a kind of a unique model where you can transfer money only through your mobile without knowing the account number. These kind of transformational platforms that this government has given not only to India but many countries who can actually adapt and fine-tune as per their requirement, this is the success story of India, and the credit goes to these 2-3 aspects, and one, the vision, detailed planning, and equally meticulous execution and very thorough monitoring. So these are very standard management lessons we'll learn. Many of us are in businesses, and they adopt this kind of criteria and path in their business world. But Prime Minister Modi has adopted the same principles in a big way, in a massive scale. And I guess this is the unique value proposition which Prime Minister Modi brings to the table as far as any political leader of any country is all about.
Vijay Chathawali, really appreciate your time today. Thank you very much for joining us here at the India Global Forum UAE.
Thank you. Thank you very much.